and gentlemen, welcome back to the newest episode of Heavy Metal Music Theory. Today you are in for a treat as we are doing one of the most amazing songs ever written in rock. It's by one of rock and metal's most famous and notorious bands, most influential bands of all time. We're going back to the late 60s with Led Zeppelin, and we're doing their finest, at least in terms of popular culture. We have Stairway to Heaven. All right, now this song has many different sections. It also contains one hell of a killer guitar solo. We're not going to be worrying about the guitar solo here. We're just going to go through the chord structure. I'll put up the chords for the specific sections as we go. We're starting with an A minor chord. All right, that's where we're starting. It's going to be a theme throughout. We're going to assume that we are in the key of A minor. All right, now the next chord is an interesting one. They have it listed as an E augmented. That's what the little plus sign is. So an E major chord is that. An E augmented is where you take that fifth, the third note of the chord, not the third, but the fifth, and move it up a half step. And you get that, okay? And if you rearrange those notes and still play the same notes in a different voicing, in a different order, you get what's also called a C augmented chord. So you have two augmented chords that share the same notes, okay? I'm not gonna go into augmented chords here, but just know that I'd like to actually think of that as more of a C augmented, because then you have the G sharp as the focal point. Now the G sharp is going to create a walking bass line pattern where we're going to go from the A of the A minor to the G sharp of the E augmented. Okay, now there is an E chord and a C chord in the key of A minor, so it really doesn't matter how we approach this, but the E augmented possesses that G sharp, which they are putting in the bass on purpose to create the sense of chromatic descension down the chromatic scale, essentially outlining the different chords of the key of A minor as we go. So the A minor chord is the one, the E augmented, we could look at it as the five, but more importantly, we're looking at it as a vehicle for the G sharp. All right, that G sharp is super important because from A to G sharp is a half step down. We're starting our chromatic descension, and we're followed there by the C chord, which has a G in the bass. All right, another chromatic half step down. The C chord is the third in A minor. We're then followed by the D chord, which is technically not in the key of A minor. There is, however, a D chord in the key of A major as the four chord. And that does possess the major quality. It does have the F sharp, which is also the bass note. So now we've gone from A to G sharp, G, and then F sharp with the D on top, all right? The next chord is the F chord, which is the sixth chord of A minor. And that kind of completes our five note descending chromatic bass line, because the next chord is the G chord, which is the seven chord of A minor, which then brings us back home, all right? So that's the first section. And obviously rock songs, natural minor scales, harmonic minor scales, typical, right, for that. But what really makes this cool is that descending bass line, using notes from all the chords, typically the thirds, sometimes the fifths, to create that lineage, that link of all those chords with the bass notes. On to the next section. We are in technically, we could still be in the key of A minor here. We're focusing on a D chord for this section, which is then leading to the A minor chord and then an E minor chord. So we could assume that were in A minor, but we're just starting on the major four, which again is pulled from the parallel major A minor. I'm sorry, A major. So A major, the A major scale, contains a D major chord as the four chord. And that's what we're starting on. So we're starting strong with the major, and then we're going to the A minor, which is the one. And then we're going to the E minor, which is pulled from the natural minor of A minor. And then we're doing a D, C, D. All right. Just a quick short on that section. The D would be, of course, again, the major four from the parallel major, A major. And the C, again, is the three chord in A minor. On to the next and final section. This is probably my favorite part of the song. Part there precedes the guitar solo, and we are doing the D chord. All right, it's a major chord. It's followed up by a D sus 2, which means you're getting rid of the major third and playing the 2 instead. Now, this part's a little vague because, as I stated earlier, when the D major chord came in, I link it to the A major, parallel major of A minor as the four chord. In this case, it's a little vague because we're not just getting the major chord, we're also getting the sus 2 and the sus 4. So we're going D major, D sus 2, D major, D sus 4. And those susses don't really belong to a major or a minor. They're just kind of there. They add drama and suspense to your progression, as you can tell by the way this feels when it's played. Once you've done that, you then bring in the C chord and the C add 9 chord, right? And the 9 is just there for color. The C would be the 3 chord in A minor. If you wanted to get really fancy, you could also link the C chord to being the 7th note of D minor, but we're not in D minor. The D chord is a major chord. So we're really borrowing a lot of different chords from a lot of different places here, and it ultimately just comes down to what sounds good in the moment. So this section just sounds really good on its own. It might even be that the 4 of the A major scale and the C is the 3 of the A minor scale, and we're intermingling chords from the two parallel keys, most of them coming from A minor and a couple of them coming from A major, both starting on A. Those are called parallels, and it really works well. The sus sound with the add 9 also works really well. The cool thing about the add 9 is that the add 9 and the sus 2 are very similar. They're both the 2, but the add 9 contains the major third, and the major third is not present in a D sus 2 or a D sus 4. But with the C add 9, you do have the major third and the 2. The reason it's called the 9 is because we're not going to call it a C major add 2 or a C major sus 2. The fact that it's a major chord means that we now have to name that 2, which is actually the 9, we have to name it from the perspective of the 9 because we've already used the major structure. So we always name our chords by the highest interval used. So if we were doing a C sus 2, it wouldn't have the major third. But because it's a C add 9, it's got the major third and the 2, but we call the 2 the 9 because it's above. Hope that made sense. As always, guys, thank you for watching. Hit like, hit subscribe, leave a comment. Let me know you're alive, and we'll see you next time.